Your Excellencies, it is with great pleasure I stand before you here today, honored to have been a part of the 8th General Assembly of the ICAP. These past few days prove that ICAP is a true regional platform of dialogue and cooperation and can be instrumental in moving Asia towards economic and social prosperity. As a national organizer, on behalf of the United National Party, we are proud to have co-hosted this tremendous event and look forward to meet the outstanding delegates at another ICAP General Assembly once again. As leaders of our nations, we must cultivate our relationships so as to improve the unions between our countries. Honorable Maithripala Sirisena and Honorable Chandima Virakkudi, as well as the officials from the Minister of External Affairs of Sri Lanka, must also be strongly commended for their part in successful organizing this assembly. Centuries ago, Asia was the reigning global power. The East, with its great rulers and rich history, led the world. These last few decades have seen a reversal of the current world order and the emergence of a multipolar world. Today, Asia is host to over 4.4 billion people, and our neighbors China and India are leading the Asian desire for development and prosperity to regain our place in the global power play as equal partners. For Sri Lanka, the hosting of this conference is particularly significant given its geopolitical importance. When Sri Lanka was under colonial rule, even the British Empire recognized its strategic positioning as the hub of Asia. It is my hope that as we continue developing our country in a path towards regaining our due position in the post-conflict reconciliation period and with the involvement in regional bodies like the ICAP, Sri Lanka can once again become a vulnerable focal point and aid in the social and economic integration of Asia political actors, including my party, the United National Party, intend to play the important role of gateway to Asia in supporting the desire for stronger regional cooperation. I want to personally thank the Standing Committee of ICAP and its membership for their trust in electing the UNP as a vice chairperson of this conference. We are the oldest political party in Sri Lanka with a rich history that dates back to campaigning and bringing about independence for Sri Lanka from the British Empire. I promise you that we have taken this responsibility seriously and are grateful for the opportunity to show the delegates of this conference the diverse political landscape of Sri Lanka. A unique feature of the ICAP is that it is a forum for all political parties, not just the ones in power, be they big or small. Both the ruling and opposition parties have participated in this year's conference, allowing for a meaningful participation and balanced perspective on individual situation and the view of Asia as a whole. As the opposition party, we hope to lend our strength into ensure that this feature of the ICAP remains. As the founding chairman pointed out in the opening of the standing committee meeting on the 18th, the ICAP is already playing a role in the integration of Asia. However, as he also rightly highlighted, there are still many issues to be addressed within Asia, and the ICAP can be used as a tool to renew and mobilize our diplomatic efforts towards economic and social integration. We must not forget that Asia is home to large number of marginalized and vulnerable communities and groups. Over 31% of South Asian live below the poverty line. The youth unemployment rate in the region lies over 10% and is 3 times greater than those of adults. 79% of human trafficking is used for sexual exploitation, with the victims being mostly women and girls, as highlighted by our good friend and colleague Vijay Jolly, who is the global convener of BJP under Prime Minister Modi's government. The number of people estimated to become permanently displaced climate refugees will exceed staggering 200 million by 2050. However, there are always two sides to every story. It is the poverty stricken that are now the newly emerging middle class who are paving the way towards economic sustainability. It is the long overlooked women in our society who are participating in the workforce and boosting our economic growth. It is the ever-growing youth population that are leading the change in innovating development and new thinking. I have only mentioned three sections of our society who only need a little help from us to turn their misfortunes into fortunes. There are many more people in our countries and in Asia that can benefit from their elected officials working together. What they need to be is to become stakeholders rather than beneficiaries. I would like to state here that initiative to strengthen meaningful participation of both women and youth in the ICAP structure are timely and called for. We must take leadership by setting an example in ensuring youth and women participation, and the ICAP Women's Win and Youth Win are the step towards achieving this goal. After these days of enlightened discussion and spirited debate, I am even more confident that despite the differences between our respective countries in terms of politics, religion, ethnicity, ideology and culture, our diverse interests align in that we are all willing to come to the table and work together in building a strongly integrated region. A strong regional cooperation can cut across these lines and help us to overcome obstacles and share best practices. This conference can therefore be seen as a stepping stone towards building an Asian community. Let me conclude by stating that it is important for us to recognize and harness our political power to better our countries. Many issues have been discussed, ranging from women's rights to youth empowerment to environmental measures, but we must keep in mind that simply talking is not enough. It is imperative that our words become action and our action have a long-lasting impact. We must think globally and act locally. Only then can we build an Asian community. And I should thank Mr. Chung that if he is not, I think that, you know, this conference is that not successful like this. Thank you very much.
To bring Asia together. Chairman as well. Prosperity or combined feeling of
in a great body of participants.